Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. And today it's still me, Portal. Me, Sparky. I'm not Paul. I'm joined by Portal. And today, and we're going to have Gamers Attitude versus Ken Bone for skins. And just before we get into this game, we want to say a quick thank you to our sponsors, because without them, we wouldn't be able to do it tonight. That's going to be AOC Gaming, Go, Malta Tourism Authority, esportsgaming.bet, My Nay, and GT Omega Racing, and the Gamers Lounge. Now, we're going to be going into this knife round to find out who's going to be able to start on the CT or T side. Then we can get into this game, Portal. How are you doing, and are you excited for this next game?
I'm doing fine, thank you, Sparky, and I am indeed looking excited. I'm excited for this next game. That's what I'm trying to say. Ken Bone for skins, winning the knife round, and probably okay. They're going to be opted to go for that CT side. I did think they were going to be going for that. Oh, and I haven't muted one of the players. but yeah, they do start off on that CT side, and yeah, I think this game is going to be good. Hopefully, it's going to be a lot better to watch than the last game. It wasn't really a close game at all. 16-6, I believe. But yeah, hopefully this game has more to offer for you guys to keep you entertained. Not that you guys aren't entertained already, because you know you've got me and Sparky here casting. What more can you ask for on a for Wednesday night? There we go. I'm not with it, okay? It's been a long week, guys. But we are back for some CS action tonight, which is good to see.
Yep.
So good.
Yeah, I mean, Cash is making another return. If you were joined with us last week, three times out of three games, we had Cash. And so Mirage was a nice change up in the last one, but Cash is saying, like, we're coming back again. And it's making a return here into our second game.
Nothing wrong with a bit of Cash in my eyes, Sparky. It does get overplayed a bit, but you know, the viewers, they seem to like it. So Redham, can he land one of his shots here? He has been firing away. Rossman unable to connect there. Actually does connect though. He does do a bit of damage, but unable to seize the kill. And the T side, they've got control of B main here, so probably going to be working with that unless Blank can do anything towards mid, and he is unable to do so. Gets taken out quickly by Karsafu, and the rush is on. They've been spotted. Redrum, there we go. Picks up that kill onto Orpi, and it's a 3v3, Sparky. Here we go. The split onto B is going to be commencing, and it does look to be good here for the T side. Two quick kills there coming in from them, and it's all up to Sizzu alone in a 1v3. Can he do it, Sparky? He is CT. Question is, will he connect his shots?
He needs to right now. He can pick up one, but of course the whole team, I was about to say, the whole team decided not to go for a defuse kit this time. So if that bomb goes down, he needs to start pushing soon, because he hasn't got long to go ahead and defuse that bomb. But of course it doesn't matter, as the player is going to be able to pick him up. So Gamers Attitude, they're going to be able to get themselves the first round.
That is true. They do get themselves that round. They did get a bit close to comfort when they were struggling to get mid there on the T side. I thought that the CTs might end up overtaking them in terms of numbers. But overall, Gamers with Attitude take the first round after winning the pistol. Because, you know, that is the first round. What am I saying? But the CTs have opted to go into a buy here. Really common. Gone for 5-7. So the T side, it's not going to be an easy round here. They have got to play this one carefully. Do not want to be pushing into any stacks. So, doesn't look like they're going to be doing that. They are going to be playing it passive this round, so good on them. Do not want to be seeing any weapons being thrown away for no reason.
Yeah, going to decide to not get too aggressive as of late. You know, at the moment, it does look like Gamers Attitude. They look like they want to go towards A, but of course, this player deciding to go back, and he is going to be taken down at least. So, it is going to be a 1-for-1 trade, yeah. But of course, they can easily just get it back again.
That is true.
They've regained it, and now it looks like they're going to go back to A here. They're going to stick with their push, but of course they're not able to really push out at the moment. At least they can pick up another kill here, but they need to maybe start getting aggressive. But maybe because they know they're on those 5-7s, they want to keep the range on their side, so they're just staying back and trying to push. But at the moment, the Ross man is going to be able to pick up one. Orpi, of course, with another one trading straight back again, and Blank's now going to be coming from highway. They have no idea, but unfortunately isn't able to pick up the kills. Only a bit of tags from all, but of course there's too many, and they're completely distracted, and he can just come from behind, and it means Orpi can get himself two.
Yeah, so they do take the second round. There, not many weapons. Well, actually, a lot of weapons. What am I saying? The 5-7s do dealing damage there from that long range. But it is good to see that they won that round. I mean, if they threw that round away, it'd be looking like the last game, just throwing away worthless rounds. But they do capitalise off the pistol buy and a nice bit of team damage there coming in from Red Drum there.
The love taps, mate. That's what they are.
That's true.
Gives a, yeah, so, you know, it's a little push. Go on, boys, let's go. I mean, probably not the best way to do it by, you know, knifing your teammate in the back, but...
That is true.
We've got to go with it anyway, and at the moment, Red Drum, he's going to be taken down, so now there's only three of them left alive, and, of course, the situation is not going to be good for them, as, of course, they are only onto pistols, but Dunbennett, he is going to miss that first shot with that SSG, so it does mean he does have opportunity here, so... Fast food, he can at least do some damage, but the nade's going to come and he's just going to completely run away. And so he can avoid that one. But look at this guy. He's in the sight. They've got no idea. Oh
my God.
Oh, he didn't see his foot. Oh, he's done it. There you go, Rossman. He's got one.
There we go. That's what we like to see, Sparky. A bit of ninja plays. He wasn't going for the ninja defuse, but very, very cheeky nonetheless. Does get that kill. And there's a second kill coming in there from Karsafu.
No, I mean, he's only got 26 HP. He's got nothing on his side, no armor, no utility, so it's going to be difficult for him to do this. I mean, he could actually decide to save. He might as well save that little gun he's got there. I mean, what's the point in just going for the rush? I mean, against three, 26 HP doesn't seem very likely. Might as well just keep this MP7, and there you go. It looks like they're just going to try ahead and rush him at this point. He is going to pull out the SSG in time. Will he miss him? He misses that shot, though. Trying to maybe connect the second, but unfortunately he's going to be taken down. So at least he can take one down with him.
Yeah, at least he does that with the SMG as well. It's a bit of a money boost coming into this round. CT should be able to get a buy here. The utilities, I mean, it's not the best, but, you know, they've got stuff to work with. Flashes to delay any T-sided pushes on the map. But in terms of the T-side economy, it's looking quite good right now. They've got all the utilities on the board. They've got an AWP, AKs as well. Poco still on that MP7 that he saved last round.
Flashman's going to come in. That could have been Red Drum deciding to go for that peak again, but just going to hold this one back, and there you go. Finally decides to go for that peak with his teammate. Them two working together perfectly as they can work together to get one, but now deciding maybe, well, I was just going to head back here, but maybe they decide they want to go for another peak here. They might as well. It's been successful so far, so now why not go for another one? And that's what they're going to do, and there you go. Worked out. They can get a second here, but of course that one towards mid, he's going to go down. So they could take over mid control if they want to, and maybe head over towards B, or, you know, from behind invents and take down Red Drum. But at the moment they're kind of scattered around the map at the moment as they look maybe starting to favour towards that A site. But of course this one player, Sisu, is going to be able to take him down. So they now lose another one. Just these two players left alive. They really need to decide, are they going to go for this one? I mean, they have some utility and armor as well, so they could do it. But and two of the players are tagged down to below 50 HP, but it's quite a desperate situation for them so far, and they're not really deciding to push this one together. You know, we've got one player starting to advance while the other's just going to watch from behind, you know, playing it safe at least, but it's going to be difficult for them. 30 seconds left on the clock, it's all coming away, and there's the bomb portal. I think it's all over.
Yeah, Dunbennett with the open hand. There's nothing he can do really here. In this round, you know, it got towards the end. It would have been nice just for them to play a bit more passive, see if any CTs would get a bit greedy and push, but... they weren't able to get any picks at all there. And that is the call to save, Sparky. That is not the call to run out onto the site with the bomb on your back, is it, really? It's not the right time. Call it off a bit, yeah, for the next round, maybe. But Dunbennett is going to try and save this AWP. I think he will do, because the CTs, they haven't got the economy yet just to push him, try and steal it off him. Oh, no,
take him down.
As I say that, he's down. So, good push there from Carr. For Sue, I take back what I just said. But if the T side wanted to, they could buy up the AWP again. But it doesn't look like they're going to be doing it. They have opted for AKs. And they have got a bit of utility to work with this round, Sparky. So it's not the end of the world.
Yeah.
But, yep.
I think they just went for the gamble there that they could at least pick that one up. And it works out for them. It's going to be successful. So it means now they are without an AWP. And they completely line up so Sisu can pick up too.
That's a great start for the CTs there. Quickly getting that bomb down, so that's definitely information that they are more towards a main, the T side here. But Dunbennett, he doesn't want to have any of it. Takes Poco's head clean off. As I say that, Red Drum easily gets the kill there onto Dunbennett. I mean, this is like a game of ping pong, Sparky. There's kills left, right, and centre.
It's not working out for well for them so far, but Last Plank now brings it back to that 2v2. You know, they had the advantage, and again, Bone for Skins, they're completely giving that away at the moment, but at least now Sisu is going to be able to pick up another one for his team on a free K at the moment, trying to look for that fourth in towards Blanks, but he's out towards mid, and it looks like he's going to go towards Checkers here and try and go for that B site. At least the last blow-up, so at least he does have that 1v1 opportunity for him. Is he going to be able to realise that play is there, though? I don't know what he's looking at the moment. Just looking at the fan, checking if it's operational. And, of course, Rossman's going to come from behind and fix it. Maybe he's an engineer or something, you know, just looking at it going, maybe I'll need to fix it or something. And why he's distracted by that from behind, he's going to be taken down. And so, means they lose another opportunity here. And, of course, but Ken Bone for Skins, they're going to be able to pick up and snatch two of those AKs. And now getting an AWP of their own wire. Game's Aptitude. Rut row for them. That's all they've got is pistols and two flashbangs.
Yeah, I do not expect them to be doing anything this round. Getting the bomb down would be a bonus, of course. But, I mean, I'm not even going to be expecting that. Full squad of the CZ side all have a brilliant arsenal to work with coming into this round. So, you know, Flank even unable to hit any of his shots. So that's an easy kill for Poco. And they're already down to three players, Sparky. Not looking good, because Carfuso, he's not budged from the site, is he? I mean, getting the bomb down at this point is, I'm going to rule it out. Unless the Tech-9s get up close and personal.
But so far, the CTs aren't going to let them advance. They're absolutely stuck in A main at the moment. They are tagging them, though, and he's successful. Nate's going to come in, but he's going to be finished off nevertheless, and it's not going to do a lot of damage on Nate, so not really worth it, but trying to do something there, throwing the bomb, and that is the complete wrong time as they lose another, so... Orvia, what is he going to do? I mean, he could decide to go ahead that bomb. I mean, he has to at the moment. Getting aggressive with that P250. Can pick up one. There is going to be another. Spots him out, but just gets that bomb and maybe decides he could move. No, he's going to decide to stay here. Try and go for that M4 at least, but the smoke's going to come in. So that could actually work him out. Whatever they smoke it off, it means he could pick up the M4. But and he does.
He could rush B. Oh, no, yeah, he can't.
Yeah, now from behind, unfortunately, they were completely set up perfectly, waiting for him to go, right, let's move back. And the player waits there and just shoots him down. And of course, now the money, they can easily just buy up AKs again, but utility, it's not going to be the best.
No, it's not going to be. I mean, they've got a couple of smokes to work with, so it'll be interesting to see where they decide to put them on the map. But it's the opposite, complete opposite for the CT side. They have got loads of utilities to work with, a CT's dream, in fact. But Carfuso, he's still rocking that MP7. He's not afraid, Sparky. He wants even more cash. Look how greedy that guy is. But it's not going to stop him from pushing through a smoke. He's pushed through it. That's some information for the CT side to work with. And he's established that there's no one actually in A main. So that may, you know, may lead to the CTs believing that they're actually more towards B main. And I've definitely Redrum can hear it here. There are a lot of steps. They're not trying to hide anything here, the T's. They have made a lot of noise here, but actually are falling back. So maybe that was part of the strat, Sparky. Who knows?
Yeah, Redron, he was able to see the players there, so they know there's some towards B, and of course it just means only one player's going to be towards A, as they're expecting them maybe to keep going for this one, but at the moment they're starting to rotate towards A. They are at least going to keep this one player there to keep him onto that site, keep him distracted. You can see Rossman maybe deciding to go back there, but as soon as that player started to shoot, you know, he goes straight back onto the site again, and that smoke, unfortunately, at the wrong time, can pick up one. Blank doesn't get another, so now the advantage goes into this favour, but of course we still got... this player here, he's going to try and hold this all alone while he waits for his players to rotate and help him out so far. One's going to be from above. Rossman can spray him down at least. And Kazu's still, he's holding this site. They're not letting him push at this point at the moment. Drake's going to come in now, tagged down to 21 HP. Really needs support at this moment, but unfortunately, he is going to go down. So his last two CTs are trying to set up something to hold this side at the moment, but his teammate goes down, so it's just him left alive. Can's pick up one, but from behind, has absolutely no idea in that last player, so unfortunately they aren't going to be able to pick that one, but of course they can't build up the economy as only one of their players will able to survive. You know, they need to, you know, get all of them alive, or at least, you know, three or four, and it means they can start building up that money, but at the moment we're not seeing that.
Yeah, I mean, it's still, you know, it's been close all of these rounds between the two teams, but in terms of economy on the T side, it's still not the greatest, because they've been left down to one person alive pretty much every time, or two people. So they are in the lead right now, but that is probably going to be changing if they lose this round, Sparky. But as we can see, pistols on the CT side. You would hope they wouldn't throw this round away. I'm praying. But who knows? It's CS. Anything can happen, right?
Exactly. I mean, Retrom at the moment, with that deagle, would have been good if they could at least pick up one for their team. Black now tanked down to 22 HP, and now finally going to be able to finish him off. They know exactly where this other one is, and Retrom just peeks him. So now he's got himself two for his team, so they actually have the advantage at the moment. But Chongzi is going to be waiting for that player to come there towards the CT side, but at least he can spray him down. But once again, we've got this exact same player. Oh, it's happened again to him from behind. He's taken down.
A bit of miscommunication there, I think, from the CT side, because his teammate ended up dying. I think it was Poco who peaked Z there, or Connector, whatever you want to call it. He peaked Z and died. So a bit of miscommunication that Carfusi was actually still visible to Highway there. Probably playing a bit of the dangerous side, and it's going to cost him. He gets taken out, and the CTs are unable to get the round. But they are going to be having a solid buy coming into this, Sparky. They've got enough utilities to work with here. And yeah, now is the time to start racking up the rounds. You know, get that early advantage on in the game. It's still early days, but every little helps. I'm not sponsored by Tesco's, by the way.
I was about to say,
I'm more of a Sainsbury's man myself, I'll be honest.
Yeah, I've got to agree. Yeah, I like a bit of
Sainsbury's. Sainsbury's is where it's at. Free for a pound, that's where it's at.
Yeah. Other but supermarkets game, are anyway. Available.
Yeah. We are missing the gameplay here, thanks to me. You can blame me. Sisu's already getting taken out early on into the rounds. That's not good for the CT sides, especially as well that they haven't even got any nades to work with here. I mean, they've got two HEs to work with. That's nothing, really. And two flashbangs, but it seems to be working for them, whatever's going on right now. Rossman gets two quick kills there onto Chongi being one of them. And there's still two left alive, and I don't think he realises that, but still gets the kill, spins around, manages to take the head off of Opt, lol. And I don't even know what I just witnessed, Sparky. That is a solid behold. Or it might have just been the T's missing their shots. I'm not too sure.
I think what we're seeing a lot with the problem is for the CT side, is utility. They throw them at the complete wrong time, and it's costing them their life or a lot of their health. So they really need to be a lot more careful. I mean, of course, they just won that round, but I'm saying in general, it is costing them.
Yeah, I mean, the CT side, whoever it was on that A side, I think it might have been Sisu here. He peaked last round when he was going up against the pistol. Well, two rounds ago, he peaked with a grenade in his hand. And that's something you do not want to be doing in CS because, you know, in these games, you're likely to get your head taken off, Sparky. Is it really worth it? I don't think it is, personally. So they have definitely got to be watching when they chuck the nades, because they have been getting caught off one by one. So hopefully they're going to realise that and stop doing it. But the T side here, going towards A main there. Again, they're not trying to hide anything, Sparky. They're making a lot of noise. So that might be part of the strat, you know, trying to make the CT side feel a bit scared almost that they're getting control. But it's not been working for them, because Opt, lol, does get taken out there by Rossman, and Poco is pushed from behind and is able to fall back. That is something that you do not want to happen on the T side. You should have at least one player there ready to get the exchange frag, but no player is able to do that. So the CT's at the advantage here. Three players on the T side, and it's not looking good for them here again, unless they can get a kill here. They do realise Sisu's up there, and his head gets taken off. He's playing a dangerous game, and that costs him again. But Poco in the vent position. Easy kill there onto Dumb Bennett. Will he drop? Yes, he does. Will he be able to get the second kill? He doesn't know that there's a player right in front of him. And he gets the kill anyway onto Blank. So clean round there. Well, not exactly clean, but, you know, they won the round. Did the job. That's all you need. You need the round, Spock. It's all about the rounds. No matter how many players you got alive, if you win the round, it counts towards the score. And every round helps, as I said before.
I think what's really working out well for the CT site at the moment is on towards that B site. They flash it and they push together so well, and it's worked out every time for them. They're at least able to pick up one plus kills every single time they do and survive themselves. So they've got to be very cautious towards that B site, and so far they aren't really doing that. Flashbang's going to come in. Could be a good push for them. They can pick up one, but the smoke, well, the flashbang, sorry, is going to fade away for them, so at least they can finish them off. Really needed to connect those shots there, and it's not going to work out for them, but at least the AWPer's going to be able to bounce back, gets another. Starting to get aggressive, has absolutely no IDs, tagged down ever so low, and there he is. Blank can finish him off in this 2v2. This really shouldn't have happened right now, but of course, the firepower, they're going to have a lot more, but at least Blank can snatch up that AWP and wait for this player. Takes his time, but misses a shot, and his teammate goes down, but can pick up one now, left on 5 HP.
I mean, Redrum's got two flashes here, and he will use them wisely, but unable to get the kill, Sparky. This is getting too close for comfort here, and he's going in, and Blank goes absolutely huge there for his team. Gets the kill onto Redrum, and what went wrong there for the CT side? I honestly don't know.
How did Redrum not connect the shots? He just needed to connect one. How did he not hit that?
And he was full blind.
Yeah.
Unbelievable. But I'm not too sure what happened there.
Cost him. No, that will just cost them a round. And at the point, this game's so back and forth, it's that one thing that could cost them the game.
You know, you've got to look at it like that, because when it starts getting close towards the end, you know, when things are neck to neck and you're tied up, I've been saying it. This is the third time now, Spocky. Every round helps. That round could come back to bite them in the back. But we will have to find out. Lol. He's obviously disagreeing with us. He gets the kill onto Sisu. You know, the rounds are going their direction. They don't care. Early advantage there for the T side. So the CTs, I mean, they haven't got a great buy in this round, have they? So it's looking unlikely. But they have opted to buy into this slightly.
Yeah, so far they're just going to be holding with this 5-7. Can pick up one. Will he be able to get the second? No, just misses the head there. And now, of course, this one going to be coming from mid. Picks up another. One player left alive. It's going to be the Ross man. Can he do anything with this 5-7? Does head out Mara as well. Now just starting to maybe hunt him down. He does push out, but it doesn't matter as he is going to be picked off. So, Games Attitude now maybe trying to start to extend their lead. And, of course, with the money that Kenbone have, it's not going to be a lot, so it looks like what they're going to have to do is they could possibly give away this round again, but as already one player has decided to buy up straight away, it looks like they might go ahead and go for a buy again, and that's why we're going to see a pause. Yeah, it's going to
be what we're seeing here, do you think it's a tactical? I think what might have happened is I think he might have bought, disagreeing with his team, obviously not listening to the communication, and they probably want a round restart. That's what I'm looking into this. I don't think that should be allowed if that is the case. I don't think, for the looks of it, they're not being allowed to do that. Teammates will be buying up. I don't think that's the right call at all. Just buying up an M4, no utilities at all, and he's even bought a Kevlar helmet. A Kevlar helmet? Does that make sense? A helmet? What? You know what I mean, Sparky.
Yeah, it's not needed, of course, with these four AKs. And you know they've got a lot of money, so they're going to go for this one. There's no point, really, whatsoever.
And look at Poco and Carfusu. That could be, like, an extra utility to use. And, you know, flashes, you know, they're helpful. They stop the pushes. But a helmet, is that really needed? You know that they're going to be on a solid buy, as you said. So, a bit unusual to see them buying them. But you've actually got four teammates on the CT side there. Helmets.
I think Redrum, I'm just going to assume that I think he bought up without, you know, talking to his team, and so they've just decided they're going to have to go for this force buy, where I think if they actually took this one together, that's why I think they had the tactical. They just realised, Redrum, what are you doing? And so they've gone for the pause, and they're talking over, what are we going to do now? Because we're going to have to buy, obviously. Oh. And Optal is going to be able to get the first one. I mean, what they should have done, really, is try and balance their economy once again, with maybe some people buying up, some not, just a little bit different, but it looks like they're just going to go for a full-on force buy here, and their economy still may be a little bit different. But, of course, at the moment, Poco at least can pick up one for his team, bringing it back to the 4v4.
Yeah, so who knows, Sparky? This buy could end up working out for them, but that is something we'll have to see. And when Rossman is wide-peeking like that, it's definitely not helping the cause, is it? Easy kill from him. He's not going to be missing that shot because he has looked to be on point in this round with that AWP. I mean, he's been on point with it all game, actually. It's been safe to say. The T side here, I've got highway control. Easy kill that onto Carfusi, the flash doing its job right there. But Poco, he's the one man to hold on A site. Unable to do so. Does get the first kill, but does get taken out shortly after. And that is the bomb, Sparky. What has gone wrong here then? Dunn Bennett is the last alive against Sisu. And he's got an AWP. Misses the shot. Oh my gosh, this is... Can he do it? This is the question. I mean, it's not the ideal position for a bomb to be. I don't know what that guy was thinking.
Oh, he just flew there. I don't know what's going on. He's going to go for that flashbang. Of course, he does have the bomb, but he's not going to check to his left here, so it may cost him. He's going to be above on sandbag. Sees his head drop up from above. There he goes, drops down, but no, can't connect the AWP shot. So Dunn Bennett just going to be able to take that one away, and he shouldn't have. To be honest, I think the AWP should have been able to do that one.
He didn't manage to save the AWP at the end. I think he dropped his weapon. Yeah, look how expensive it is for Op Lola. He's just wasted $7,450 from his economy, right? And yeah, I know, Op didn't even get anything out of that. Well, no, sorry, Don Bennett didn't. He chucked his ache out of the map. Don't know why he was chucking his ache out of the map there. Obviously trying to get the AWP, but money down the drain. Unnecessary, really, but not going to cost them, really, because it should be an easy round here, unless Poco can do anything crazy. Gets the first, but that's an easy kill for Op Lola. He's not going to be missing that at close range with a Tech 9. But 9-5 right now for Game is with Attitude. It's going to be a good buy coming into this round for Ken Bone with skins. But, I mean, what would you say is a realistic scoreline for a CT side on cash? Would you say around 8-7?
Something close. I think this map's quite close. I mean, of course, got to favour that CT side maybe a little bit more. But at the moment, that's been completely proven wrong, as Games of Attitude has been very well successful towards that D side. I mean, that strat really, what Ken Bone, I don't know what they're doing, just starting to push towards Garage with all of them. And unfortunately, a lot of the T sides were there. And I think that's a problem. They just couldn't deal with it. Maybe they needed to wait a little bit more time after they spread out more, then decide to go for the push. But nevertheless, they're not going to lose out anyway. But of course, now with these rifles, it's not been successful, as they've already lost two. And now they're just starting to advance towards this map. Of course, now favouring towards A. They've still got that one player towards going from behind, possibly could do something. But of course, they're not going down without a fight so far, as the player's going to be able to pick up two. And Chonga as well, going to be able to pick up one. So bringing it back to that 2v2 situation.
Yeah, so the good thing that I've been seeing is the CTs, they're not afraid to actually peek. So that's, you know, it's a good thing. They've been getting the kills, but you've got to argue, are they peeking too much, Sparky? He gets two kills. That is the right time just to tuck in and wait for your teammates to support you. But Carfusi there getting a bit greedy, I think, and over peaking that a bit, and that will cost them, and it might indeed cost them the round, Sparky. It is the last round of the half. Carfusi with the AWP in hand.
He's going to have to do anything though.
Yeah, I mean B site as well, like, that's a really hard site to retake. And with the AWP, it's not making things any easier. He's got no utilities, and he can't save because it is the last round. I don't know. We can't really expect anything here.
Bomb is ticking away, and there it is. No minute going to be able to finish him off here. 10-5 is going to be the score in towards the first half. So maybe at least they've been able to get, you know, the minimum requirement, at least towards that CT side. But a little bit more would have helped them out, but this is the situation that they've been put into. So, of course, we're going to have to see, are they going to be able to bounce back this one, or is Game of Attitude going to be able to finish this one off?
Yeah, well, as we were talking about last game, if the CT side do want to come back into this, they do need to win the pistol round. I mean, they can lose it, but, I mean, it's not going to do them any favours, I think. I think everyone wants to win the pistol round. It's definitely going to help Ken Bone for skins coming into this next half. So 10-5 is the score. Games of Attitude slightly above Ken Bone in terms of rounds, but not much in it, really. If they win the pistol round, they should be all right.
Yeah, I think it was that ending, as you can see there, just on a clean sweep there on towards the T side there towards the end. You know, it was so back and forth, but in towards the end of the half, I think the T side, they were just on it, and they just completely took it away towards the end. So, of course, it means they are going to have the advantage and not deciding to go for a buy blank here. I mean, he's just going to save completely. They're going to have absolutely, they're going to have no defuse kit whatsoever. So they really got to rely on the Angels right now, as they don't want to really give away that site towards the Ken Bone side.
Yeah, I mean, that's not something I've seen before, really, on a pistol round. You definitely want to be buying something. And the B site has been taken, I think, because Blank, he's run out of bullets. That's a bit embarrassing. Opt, though, does make things a little easier for the CT side. Gets the first, but Carfusi is quickly to put it back in their favour. 2v3 now for the CTs. Retaking B site. It's not looking good. And yeah, Chonky misses all of his shots. So I think that just about finalises the round. That's all that does. I mean, Redrum doesn't even care. Without a care in the world, storms in with the knife, going Rambo style. No respect, Sparky. No respect. Up close and personal.
So extra money right there with that knife kill. That will help them out. And of course, you can see what they're going for with that buy. Gamer's Attitude, they know what they're going to have to go for here. It's really got to be some sort of a force buy. I mean, it's not a lot. They're deciding to go for the pistols, and what's one of them going for the head armor, but he's already dinked down to quite low here, and the nade's going to finish him off, but at least he's been able to pick up two for his team. That will help him out. Even if they don't do anything here, at least they can do a little bit of damage to the economy their side, but... Oh, no. Yeah, exactly.
That is exactly the point. I mean, an easy round, you could argue. That could be thrown away unless Carfusu can do anything here. He has got the MP7 and the Molotov, sorry. So it'd be interesting to see how he uses that. Probably chucked it towards quad there. But no, that's an interesting position to chuck the Molly. Must have failed it slightly. I don't know if he realises there's a guy underneath him, but he does realise it apparently. Dom Bennett gets taken down and it's all up to Call Me Orpy with no Kevlar. He has got a flashbang, however, so... Probably not going to be using that, though, actually. He does want to try and keep his position secret. And I think he might have heard Carfusu there, quad. Yeah, he has. But then again, Call Me Orpy is really blatant there, making noise on top of the red container. And that will cost him his life and the round. So, Ken Bonefist skinned almost through that round out of the window. But... they do get it in the end, Sparky, which is nice to see. And they are starting to make a comeback. It's what we all wanted to see. I mean, CTs are not going to have a great buy. They have opted for pistols again. But again, Ken Bone for skins should take this. It should not come as close as it did last round, Sparky.
Don't know what happened there. You know, as soon as one team got the advantage, they completely threw it away on both sides.
Yeah.
Not working out good for them, but of course now they're starting to advance from behind. The bomb has gone all the way from behind towards B. And they've got absolutely no idea. They still have this player, though, that could do something. Or B, at least, but he's going to be able to get a few tags. But now Carfusu is going to be coming from behind. He is going to be able to realise where he is, but only going to be able to tag him down to 54 HP. And so that now means the bomb's going to go down. And these last two players, are they going to decide to go for this retake or just save it here? No, it looks like they want to go for the aggression, working together well so far. But of course, the knowledge is going to be known. They know where the last two players are, so it's going to be a lot easier job for these last few players. Nate's going to come in. He's going to dig him down to 74 HP, but he's just going to re-peek him straight away. He knows where he is, and there you go. Rossman going to finish off the last. So Ken Bone here looks like they're trying to come back at the moment.
Yeah, it does certainly look that way. And another round in the bag for them. The CTs will be buying this round, however. They have got utilities. Well, yeah, some utility. They've got plenty of utilities to work with this round. They will be going up against the full arsenal of the T side, though. Definitely, you could argue that they have got more nades on their side. Well, you would expect so, because they have been winning these rounds. But the T side here actually going for a quick A push with 1 minute 40 on the clock still. So, will this catch the CTs by surprise? I think it has. Chongi gets taken out by Rossman there, and they don't even care. They chucked the cross smoke. That was it. They went out quick, and that's definitely a play that I like seeing. They changed up the variation. They've definitely been doing things very slowly there on that T side so far. And just to change it up like that has such a perfect effect on the CT side. They're not expecting it at all, really. And it has cost them dearly. Call Me Orpy last alive against two players. Can he do it, Sparky? That is the question. One flashbang and a kit. I mean, we've seen the clutches this game before. Can he do it? He's running out of time, Sparky. I'm not too sure. And that just finalises the round, really. Rossman going out big that round. Gets 3 kills just when his team needed him most. And there we go. 10-9.
The thing is, though, with that flashbang, of course, it gives him security that most likely that, you know, the players are going to be flashed when he decides to go for that initial peek. But the problem is, though, as well, it completely gives his location away. So the players just needed to hone in on his location. And so it means they can take him down. So no games of attitude trying to look for a force buy here with these 3 5 7s. And of course, it's going to come in, but just can't connect the shots here. Going to tag down to 45 HP. But look at this. Dan Bennett, though, he's going to be coming from behind. And are they going to be able to realise? I mean, if they was able to keep him on the position, he could come from behind and just completely take him out. But unfortunately, he's taken too long. So it just means a T now have advanced on towards that site. They can get this bomb down and set themselves up. But I'm going to try to maybe just keep him off balance for now as he tries to pick up. They go from behind again. Another one. So Dan Bennett's left alive. But they have absolutely no idea where he is. But he's against 1v4.
I mean, Dom Bennett has always failed to time that right. He's always been coming from behind. So I think it might be obvious this time he's coming from there because he's been taking it slowly every time and he's always been there. I mean, if he sped it up a little bit and caught them off guard that way, he could have done so much more there. But, I mean, taking that long to actually flank behind him, it's kind of worthless, really. I mean, unable to make anything from that.
Yeah, if they were able to hold them off from pushing and then he took, you know, a lot quicker time to push from behind, then it really could have worked out for them. But, of course, they couldn't hold it, so it was taken down. And then, you know, that player from behind, Dom Bennett, took too long. And so it means they couldn't really do anything with it. Of course, now starting to advance towards his safety site, there are going to be players there to hold them. Spray's going to come in, does lose one. Are they going to realise he's from above? He does get a couple of tags, but, of course, vacates back and waits for his team to offer some support. There you go, he's going to be finished off. Another one towards Van. They really need to make sure they're pushing this one together at this point. Good use of their utility as well. They don't have much, though. And still, Kenbone have a lot on their side. So there you go, at least they can take down another one. So that's going to be successful for them coming into this retake. But look at this boost by Redrum. It means he's in a nice position. He can pick up one, but no, trying to finish him off isn't going to be successful and taken down to 8 HP. But of course, with that boost, they know exactly that two are going to be towards quad.
Yeah, that is right. They did see the boost there. Really obvious there from the T side. 4v2 though. The time isn't in their favour. This is the call to save it, Sparky. And OP still challenges Redrum and wins somehow. But hopefully they're going to be saving these weapons. I don't think the T side are going to catch them. So I think they will be holding on to these M4s unless that guy out of the vents kills him. Oof, that was close. Too close for comfort there, but he does save the weapon in the end. So Kenbone for skins in the lead, Sparky, for the first time all game, I think. Who would have thought?
Six in a row so far. Game's attitude can't do anything at this point. I mean, now at least they've got a lot more convincing buy, but once again, the utility isn't going to be that much for them.
Yeah, look at that. I mean, they've got one smoke to work with here and a couple of flashes, really. It's not great for a CT side. You want as much smokes, as much incendiaries as you want. Well, as you can, sorry. Because buying time against the T side is vital on the CT side. But, I mean, you've got to argue, is it actually going to work, though? Because this T side, so far, Kenbone, they've been playing very fast. Like, since they did that A hit, they found the weakness that the CTs are struggling to hold with quick plays. So, and they're capitalizing off that, Sparky. Every round so far has been a quick round from what I've seen.
Yeah, of course, with these two CTs left alive, they are going to be able to spend up two Sue at least, so that is one for them. But of course, they've still got utility, so they can just re-smoke it off if they want to. It looked like Pathasu was going to do that then, but decides just to hold this one off, and it's only against two. There you go, one's going to start to advance, but he's picked off straight away, and now Dan Bennett, he's just going to decide to try ahead and save what he's got, as he does have a lot of money in a 1v4 situation. It's not worth it. Your money-wise isn't going to be the best as well, so it's definitely the best to do this one, but of course a round loft bonus is going to be good for them. Now with this AWP as well, Redrum, he's going to have his knife at the wrong time, but he isn't going to keep on checking. He's just going to try and run away, so it means he's going to be picked off, so they can't even save the AWP.
Yeah, I'm surprised he didn't hear him there push up towards B main. I think he might have had like a, I don't know, I think he might have heard him slightly, but obviously not quite, because he was running with his knife out. Not a good time to be caught, really. Something that I've noticed on the CT side, they used to be peeking together, really. They've not been doing that. Chongi on the A site, I think, has been peeking from sight every round. Like, he's been playing it. There's no variation whatsoever on the CT side. They've kept it the same throughout, so I think that might be one of the reasons. Like, they know Chongi's going to be there. He's been doing it every round. He's wide peeking it. What does he expect's going to happen, Sparky? You know what's going to happen? Redrum is going to capitalize off that and gets an easy kill. They're not peeking together, and that is where they're going wrong. So they do need to fix that if they want to start racking up these rounds again, which is important for them, because this is starting to run away towards Kenbone for skins, and that's something we do not want to be seeing.
Yeah, they're completely threw it away, let's be honest with you, so far on towards the CT side. You know, Kenbone just completely gone aggressive, and it's working out for them so far on towards this T side. And of course, once again, in this 2v3 situation, they should be able to pick this one off. There you go. Sisu can pick himself another one. Now it's just all of Don't Be Left Alive. And he's going to go for the save. There's no point deciding to go for this one. It cost him. He's just going to be playing for exit frags right now. Going to wait for that player to try and run away at least. And it means he could help him out. But there you go. Sisu decides to peek. He can pick up one at least. They do know his location. Are they going to decide to go for the push here? I mean, they have a lot of money, so they might as well try and take down that AWPer, as Gamers With Attitude don't have anything.
Yeah, I mean, it is not looking good at all for the CT side. And he's not even able to save the AWP, Sparky. Just put the cherry on top of the cake there. Poco erases him from the map. And once again, Sparky, they are down to minimal utility here. They've got three smokes. I mean, it's all right, but I mean, Chongi, look, that A site, he's been struggling to hold it. Maybe put a smoke down A main or something, but he's just peeking it one by one every time. It's not good. There we go. There's the smoke. Little under armor there.
Oh, there you go. That's what they need. Try and get that kill, but no, no one can finish off the kills at this point. They're able to tag them down low, but they can't finish it off.
Blank is literally just firing blanks right now. I mean, none of his bullets hitting whatsoever, and gets taken out there, and that is embarrassing. That is not what you want to be seeing there. They want every kill they can get, Sparky. And when you mess up a kill like that, I mean, not good, is it? Not good at all.
Oh, Sisu was able to spot up that player towards Quan, so all he's got to do is just keep holding, wait for that player. But of course, Ross Man is going to be there before, and he can pick it up. So just this last player left alive, and there you go. Sisu can get the flick, pick him up. And it looks like they're just taking this game away. And Gamers, I think it's all over for them now. I mean, they've lost so many in a row. I just think that, you know, mentally wise, it's just gone.
I can see that. I don't know if it's the communication or what, because they're not peeking with one another. Might be something to do with their attitude, Sparky. Not too sure. Gamers of attitude. I mean, what's gone wrong for them? They were doing everything right the first half, and it's really unfortunate to see that they're unable to do anything yet coming into this second half. But look at him. Up low, he's just running with his knife out without a care in the world, really. He's just running with his knife out. That's an easy kill for the T side. They're holding. They're not going to be pushing into anything. They don't need to be doing that. Why are you pushing that? You should hold back. You know, you're a CT. It's all right, the occasional push, Sparky, but when you're just pushing like that aimlessly, it's not going to be working in your favour any time whatsoever.
Yeah, I think Ken Bone, they've just broken at this point. You know, it doesn't look like they're all together at the moment, as you can see. Of course, well done, Ben. At least trying to at least pick up that kill. Can take him down to 34 HP, but I just can't finish it off. And there you go, he's going to take him up, but then Orphy's going to come from behind it later on events. He can pick up one, bring it back to that 2v2.
They've just heard him there reload and walk outside the vent, so that is the call to start going on the site, and that's just what they've done, Sparky. Sisu with the AWP in hand gets the kill onto Orphy, putting his name to shame there, because he does get taken out by the AWP. Nothing working in the CT's favour, Sparky. Chongi is left in a 1v2. And I do not see him doing this anytime soon. Unless he gets the first. That is promising. And Sparky.
He's dead.
I take back what I said about Chongi, right? He's the MVP right there. 1v2. And he's got enough time to defuse the bomb. So, I mean, might have been caster's curse there, working against the T side there. CT side, sorry. No, T side. I'm sorry. I'm not with it. Yeah, I don't know what just happened. He won the round, I guess, for his team. Shouldn't have happened. I mean, the one reason he won that round, I think, was down to the bomb plant position, Sparky. Now, the teammate, whoever it was, I think it was Dissu, he was covering the vents, right? But his teammate planted default, which I don't quite understand, because, you know, your teammate's holding from vents. Why don't you plant for B main or something? You know, you had the time. Your teammate was holding the angle. But overall, a foolish play there from the T side. That did cost them there.
Look at Blank with that P90. Just comes from behind and above. Just picks up two. But of course, Kafasu turns around at the right time. Can pick up one. Bring it back to the 2v2. But of course, the bomb is still there, so they need to go ahead and retake this one. They know exactly where this last player is left alive. So, is he going to decide to go for this one with the AWP? I mean, they still do have quite a lot of money, but some of them are quite low, so maybe it's definitely a better idea to try and just go ahead and save this one. Or maybe you could take the risk and try and take it a match point to them. I mean, at the moment, it looks like he might be trying to go for this one.
Yeah, I think he might be. I mean, he's gone for the FAMAS. He's dropped the AWP, so he's obviously feeling confident. They're not confident enough, Sparky. He gets taken out by AWPy. I don't think he's going to quite get his hands on the AWP. Nope, he hasn't got the AWP. But it's fine. The CTs don't need an AWP. The rifles have been working for him, I think. So they're going to stick to their guns and go with them. But the T-side economy, Sparky, I mean, you've got to argue, with gamers' attitude, even if they are picking up rounds, the T-side economy is still looking really strong. So, you know, the T-side, they could lose this round and still have enough to buy next round. So, it is a bit worrying here for the CTs, especially when the T-side are doing their quick plays here and not been working at all for the CTs. They're struggling to hold against these quick pushes. So, it's now a 5v2 and it's not looking good at all. Even after Chongi got that clutch last round, you'd think there's still some hope left in the bag. But it's now up to a retake once again on that B site. The kills are coming in quickly. Dumb Bennett gets the kill onto Rosman. The retake is on, Sparky. Can they do it? The flash goes out. Oh my gosh, there goes an NA nade. Dumb Bennett gets taken out. And Chongi, it's all left on the man himself. Gets the first. Can he get the second? Mollied out of position. And I think that's going to call it, Sparky.
To try to get
time is he's going for it. He is going for it. I don't know if he realizes the guy is there. He doesn't. Carfusi playing on the edge of the smoke.
Oh, and Chongi just teabagged him. Oh no.
Oh, that's bad.
I think what's the problem with that round is why they nearly lost that round is the aggression was too much. Like they were getting really cocky. Yep. I think that's
that
what the problem
true.
Is. I mean, you could just see it there with the teabag that they're cocky at the moment, but that aggression, they're trying to go with the knife and just then, you know, realizing it doesn't connect, so he's trying to do something and they're getting too aggressive and it's costing them, and they might actually be able to come back if they keep this going, and Games of Attitude can use that to their advantage, but so far they've lost three and it's down to that 3v2 situation. Then they're both out towards mid at the moment. They have the bomb towards aim or towards that garage, sorry, and Chongi though, he's going to be taken down. So his last player left alive hiding in Sag's bags at the moment with this P90, what is he going to do?
I don't know. Well, if there's anyone you would want in the clutch, it is Oplo. He has been doing work this game, going 21 and 23. But as I say, that gets taken out by Sisu. So 16-12, that's going to call it. Overall, brilliant play there from Ken Bones. We're actually bringing that back, Sparky. Really impressed with them, actually. Just a bit disappointing, though, for the CT side, how they couldn't close that game out. Because I think they did have more to offer, but I think the communication just wasn't there on the CT side. And overall, that will cost them. So 16-12, there's not really much more to say.
Yeah, I think it did work out for them. And definitely when they were towards that second half, they just completely obliterated their side. I think the problem is, though, the cockiness, it nearly did cost them, I've got to say. But we are going to be going into a quick break once again. We'll be back very shortly with our last game of the night. Don't go anywhere. We'll be back in just a moment. We'll be right back.